Food production is a basic human activity which accompanies humans from the earliest civilizations, from the moment when they started with domestication of animals and cultivation of land more than 10,000 years ago. Agriculture has been developing throughout the centuries, and its most significant rise occurred in the mid-20th century. Due to considerable population growth, also contributed to by the agriculture itself, the need for food these days is higher than ever. Modern agriculture production is, in most cases, highly specialized, and production intensivity has long ago stopped being environmentally sustainable. It is believed that 10 million hectares of soil is exhausted annually because of the negative effects on soil, and that approximately 2.5 million tons of pesticides and 200 million tons of chemical fertilizers enter into soil and water. In order to reduce negative effects of agriculture on Danube River basin and Black Sea water, Global Environment Facility, together with the World Bank and other implementing organizations, started a series of projects in 2002 in order to promote good agriculture practice and sustainable food production. Total of funds for projects amounted to more than $100 million, and 15 of Danube Basin region countries were included. The last country in the number of countries to be included in the activity was the Republic of Croatia, with the Agriculture Pollution Control Project. The project is a grant of total value of $5 million. Its main goal, positive impact on water and soil condition and education of producers, the project was supposed to achieve through four groups of activities. Investment fund, promotion of good agriculture practice, raising of public awareness and education, and project management and monitoring. The project started in August of 2008, and it was joined to the already existing framework project, Croatian Agriculture Aquicohesion Project, financed from the World Bank's funds. The project started its full operational activity after the employment of a team and external consultants in the spring of 2009. The immediate project team consisted of a leader, two employees for the implementation of the investment fund, and three country leaders, total of six people. The project unit is located within the Ministry of Agriculture, Investments Department in the paying agency in Agriculture, Fisheries and Rural Development. County leaders have been employed within the Agriculture Extension Service in three counties, Varaždin, Osijek-Baranja and Vukovar-Srijem. Due to already galloping economic crisis, but also intensive restructuring processes in the Croatian agriculture, the conditions found were very unfavorable. Especially because of the fact that the project also required significant contribution of farmers in the implementation of activities. In response to this, the project team introduced active principles of project management in its work. A precise system of mutual informing, constant monitoring and evaluation of activities was agreed upon. Work plan was adopted on monthly meetings of the team. At first it was adopted on quarterly basis, and then a more detailed plan was created for each month and working week. During the week, the team was free to make a schedule of key tasks, depending on their estimate. One of the first activities after forming of the team was an intensive campaign of field visits and informing of the public, in order to motivate all participants of the activity as much as possible. In order to upgrade the project management to its highest level, employees were also additionally educated within the field of presentation skills and work organization. The project investment fund of total value of $2.6 million was intended for producers from three project counties in order to adjust their farms with the requirements of the Nitrates Directive. Keeping in mind the rather difficult financial situation of producers, the project team chose an active approach and additional motivation of potential beneficiaries. After the bidding process for investment funds has started, a working group of approximately 60 farmers, about 20 per each county, was established in February 2010. These farmers were the first who were ready to participate in expensive and demanding process of preparation for investment. In the following 16 months, the duration of our bidding process, regional leaders of the project and all potential beneficiaries contacted each other every day. They assisted in the preparation of documents and directed farmers in order to help them fulfill all preconditions required for the investment.
Pomoć djelatnika bila je zaista velika i neprocjenjiva. Vjerovatno bez njih ne bismo mogli taj program realizirati. Jednostavno, u svakom trenutku kad nam je nešto zatrebalo, tu su bili. Imali smo i praktički skoro pa cijeli dan, cijele dane na raspolaganju.
Naša savjetnica nam je puno pomogla što se tiče same prijave na ovaj projekt koji smo imali ovdje, što se tiče prezentacije samog projekta i stalnih dolazaka. Čuli smo se često i telefonom i mailom i uglavnom smo stalno kontaktirali. I što se tiče samog ispunjavanja tih obrazaca i bez njezine pomoći vjerojatno se ne bismo ni mogli pravilno, na pravilan način prijaviti.
One of the biggest challenges was the legalization of old farms, which was a precondition for obtaining a building permit. In order to accelerate time-consuming procedures, local institutions authorized for issuing of documentation were also included in the activity. The banks were also contacted through the letters of intent at meetings and invited to cooperate, as farmers in most cases needed credit funds for pre-financing the investment. Upon two completed rounds of the bidding process, 66 requests were received and 50 investments were approved. The highest allowed project support per farm amounted to $80,000. Total support of the project amounted to $2.6 million. Total value of all completed investments amounted to $3.6 million. Average contribution of producers amounted to $20,000. Together with additional $10,000 of average expenses required for the documentation necessary for the construction start.
Ova investicija nam je zaista koristila da si sredimo i da si napravimo odlagališta koje u konačnici puno znače nama, a naravno i cijelom društvu u cjelini.
Bez pomoći fonda, znači njihovog financiranja, koje je bilo 75% od ukupnog iznosa, znači bez PDV-a, ne bismo mogli tu investiciju privesti kraju. Zbog toga što je to za nas veliki iznos i zato smatramo da je taj projekt veoma važan i za nas, a i naravno i za očuvanje prirode, pogotovo očuvanje voda.
Zahvaljujući APCP-u i njihovim djelatnicima u našoj županiji, ostvarili smo povrat od 75% sredstava koja smo utrošili u izgradnju lagune, znači završnog spremnika.
In the surroundings of the most of investments, piezometers have been installed, wells deep 5 to 30 meters used for analysis of underground water. total of 100 piezometers were installed, and these piezometers will stay as an integral part of the future control points network under the supervision of Croatian Waters. For the duration of the investment program, individual success of farmers and completed investments were presented through organizing of Open Doors Day. There farmers could have learned about applied technology and all steps required for the implementation of investments. First activity of the project within the component was the distribution of the Good Agricultural Practice manual composed by Croatian agriculture experts. The manual was printed at the beginning of 2010 by the project funds and distributed at addresses of all registered agriculture producers. Total of 85,000 copies containing all important information regarding measures and procedures of environment protection within agricultural production. In autumn of 2010, the demonstration program of good agricultural practice in farming started. Contracts on cooperation were concluded with 87 farmers, and finally in autumn of 2011, more than 1,400 hectares of farming land entered into the program. Farmers sowed cover crops in accordance with recommendations in order to keep soil covered as long as possible, making a positive influence on fertility and other valuable soil characteristics. In order to obtain project support and refund for sowing expenses, all contracted farmers had the obligation to participate in subsequent results analysis and techniques promotion.
Najvažnije što mogu reći o dobroj poljoprivrednoj praksi koju mi provodimo sad već par godina je to da smo smanjili korištenje mineralnog gnojiva zbog toga što iz stajskog gnoja, kao što vidite, imamo dovoljno i naučili smo znači primjenu sideracije, te u budućnosti se nadamo da će se nam pokazati i veći prinosi.
Kod projekta Demo plohe dobili smo dvostruku sjetvu i dvostruku žetvu u istoj godini i time smo povećali količine hrane za stoku koja nam je najvažnija. Time smo i povećali strukturu i poboljšali strukturu tla u proizvodnji.
Poljoprivredna zadruga već 2 godine u programu dobre poljoprivredne prakse i nakon prve godine po skidanju i zaoravanju toga usjeva radilo se o talijanskom ljulju i o faceli, napravili smo analizu zemljišta i vidjeli smo da je povećana plodnost tla, zemlja je bila rahlija i nakon analize smo vidjeli da nam treba manje mineralnih gnojiva, dakle za sljedeću godinu smo imali manje ulazne troškove, a te sljedeće godine smo dobili puno veće prinose.
In order to inform farmers about the latest facts regarding quantity of required fertilization of popular crops, the project started cooperation with the Faculty of Agriculture in Osijek and then with the Faculty of Agronomy in Zagreb on applied researches. As it was important to follow local interests of producers, but also natural preconditions, fields for testing cereals were set in Slavonia and fields of vegetable crops in northwest Croatia. In addition to this, at the faculty in Zagreb, a research of the quality was pre-locating water in soil under intensive plantations was conducted. Interested farmers were informed about the results of these researches in order to give them actual information about the best procedures in fertilization management.
U sklopu tih istraživanja imali smo postavljene pokuse na 3 pilot lokacije. Lokacije su izabrane s obzirom na različite tipove poljoprivredne proizvodnje. Jedna je bio tipični ratarski plodored, drugo je bilo integrirani plodored sa stočarskom farmom. Treći je bio plodored sa povrćarskom proizvodnjom. To su bile ujedno 3 lokacije sa 3 različita tipa tla. Znači na jednom cijelom području dobili bi podatke kako različiti tipovi poljoprivredne proizvodnje utječu na onečišćenje podzemnih voda.
U okviru projekta kontrole onečišćenja iz poljoprivrede Проведено е истражување во Варашдинското Жупаније со водечи повртни културама и то на купусу, кромпиру и паприци, у цилју истражување реакција или одзива повртни култура на гноидбу душико.
Подпројект унутар АПЦП-а кој се односи на оптимизација гноидбе душиком за усјеве рађен је у две жупаније, у Вуковарско-Сремској, локација Ћелије и овде у нашој жупанији, Осечко-Барањској, у Шљивошевцима. Дакле, вегетацијским калибрацијским покусом покушамо утврдити колико је заправо довољно душика за највиши могући принос, да то буде економски сплативо и еколошки, да не буде оптеречење околиша, дакле да немамо сувишак душика у подземним водама, а то је заправо највећи проблем, јер душик је лако покретан у тлу, минерализира се из органске твари и због тога се тешко заправо дозира потребна количина. Дакле, подручје у Шљивошевцима и подручје у Ћелијама. Ово је шема покуса, дакле, врло сложен покус, рандомизирани блок, возима пшеница, соја са пиезометарским гњездом и кукуруз.
In order to be better prepared for future researches and cooperation with farmers, the project donated modern analytical equipment to the faculties, which was instantly used in the laboratories of both institutions.
Sufinanciranjem iz projekta APCP, Agronomski fakultet kao sudionik projekta nabavio je instrument TOC analizator. TOC analizator služi za analizu ukupnog organskog ugljika u uzorcima tla i vode. Na ovom instrumentu određivan je ukupni organski ugljik i organski dušik u uzorcima tla i vode koji su prikupljeni za potrebe projekta. U daljnjim istraživačkim projektima Agronomskog fakulteta ovaj instrument će imati jako veliku primjenu.
The entire activity oriented towards the promotion of good agricultural practice was additionally enhanced by numerous workshops and field days organized in order to exchange acquired knowledge and benefit of implemented techniques. Public activity had the highest priority from the very beginning of the project and also because of the fact that it had a supportive role in the implementation of all other activities. Due to a rather short time framework and need to be directly included in the activity, the project team planned out the PR campaign. In 2009, seminars and presentations for farmers started, led by county leaders in cooperation with the experts from the Agriculture Extension Service.
U programu smo naučili dosta, iako nikad ne možeš naučiti i znati sve. Mi smo nakon tih demonstracija, s obzirom da se bavimo i poljoprivredom, vidjeli kaj znači napraviti plodored i držati se plodoreda. To u konačnici znači i daleko bolje prinose i daleko kvalitetniji proizvod.
Svaka edukacija je veoma bitna. Posebno što smo mi naučili je bilo da je vrlo važno zaoravati žetvene ostatke, izmjenjivati plodored. Konkretno kod nas to je bio DTS ječam, te kasnije će biti kukuruz i sirak. A vrlo je važno i koristiti više stajskog gnoja naspram mineralnog.
In 2009, an informational web page was created providing news as well as educational materials. A special place takes the so-called Farmers Club page containing information about project's beneficiaries, their production and location in order to ensure their mutual communication and knowledge transfer. In order to achieve the highest quality of presentations and education, 20 different educational and promotional materials were designed and produced in quantity of 65,000 pieces to be used during education. A very interesting part of the promotion and rising of public awareness was water wells analysis. Being aware of the fact that producers have to show personal interest for the water pollution problem, during 2011 and 2012, a water wells analysis campaign has been conducted. More than 60 municipalities participated in the campaign and more than 2,000 water wells were sampled. At the very beginning of the campaign, some of the producers had their doubts. Some of them even felt repulsion. But the campaign became very popular, and the project employees were hardly able to analyze all samples that were brought. During the conduct of this campaign, certain municipalities and cities participating in the promotion were of great assistance and unselfishly helped by providing public space. During all these years, the cooperation with the media was excellent. All important local and national media, radio, newspapers, internet portals and television informed about the project activities. The project employees were frequent guests in special broadcasts, and the media representatives were regularly present at the all important events, reporting about them. After the first 3 years of implementation, the project made certain savings within its budget. For the implementation of any project, the most important is a fast and functional commitment of funds. In order to commit the funds in the most useful way and in order to increase the viability of project ideas, the project started with the implementation of two studies of high national importance. The first one is a study nitrates vulnerable zones in the Republic of Croatia, and the second a proposal of agri-environmental program for the Republic of Croatia. Results of both studies will represent significant support to decision makers in making important decisions on the implementation of the Nitrates Directive and Agri-Environment Program in the Republic of Croatia. All efforts, cooperation and positive striving will be pointless if the idea about sustainable food production will not be continued by new generations. In order to modestly contribute to global strivings, the project at its very end has started a cooperation with 5 vocational secondary schools where future farmers are being educated. In cooperation with teachers and students, several workshops on water testing and lectures for more than 200 students were held. In order that students get to know the themes they had been informed about, a study tour was organized for them and a visit to environmentally friendly producers who are the best example of the sustainable management implementation. Through this inspiring cooperation, the project rounded up its activity.